We want to describe the type or nature of the solutions to the given quadratic equation. To do this, we'll use the discriminant, which is equal to b squared minus 4ac. Looking at the quadratic formula, notice that the discriminant is the number underneath the square root. And when we find this number, there are four possible outcomes. First, if b squared minus 4ac is greater than 0, and it's a perfect square, there are two real rational solutions. Remember, if this number is a perfect square, this will simplify perfectly, again, giving us two real rational solutions. If b squared minus 4ac is greater than 0 and not a perfect square, then this would not simplify perfectly, and this would give us two real irrational solutions. Next, if b squared minus 4ac is equal to 0, we have one repeated real rational solution. Again, if this number underneath here is 0, we would only have one real rational solution, and we can also say that it would have a multiplicity of 2. And the last case is if b squared minus 4ac is less than 0 or negative, we would have two complex solutions, and that's because if the number underneath the square root is negative, it would simplify to an imaginary number with I. Now we'll look at an example of each case. Here we have x squared minus 3x minus 28 equals 0. So a is equal to 1, b is equal to negative 3, and c is equal to negative 28. So our discriminant, b squared minus 4ac, would be equal to negative 3 squared minus 4 times 1 times negative 28. Now we need to be careful when simplifying this. Negative 3 squared is equal to 9, and there are a couple ways of simplifying this. We can think of this as negative 4 times 1 times negative 28, which would be plus 112. We could also think of this as 9 minus, and then positive 4 times 1 times negative 28, which would be negative 112. And then when we simplify minus a negative, it becomes plus a positive. So either way, this is equal to 121. And 121, of course, is positive, but it's also equal to 11 squared, so it's a perfect square, which means this quadratic equation has two real rational solutions. Next we have x squared minus 4x plus 12 equals 0. So again, a is equal to 1, b is equal to negative 4, and c is equal to positive 12. So our discriminant, b squared minus 4ac, would be negative 4 squared minus 4 times 1 times 12. Well, negative 4 squared is 16, so we have 16 minus, this would be positive 48. So this difference is negative 32. So because the discriminant is negative, when applying the quadratic formula, this would simplify to an imaginary number, which means we have two complex solutions. Next we have negative 2x squared plus x plus 5 equals 0. So a is equal to negative 2, b is equal to positive 1, and c is equal to positive 5. So b squared minus 4ac is going to be equal to 1 squared minus 4 times negative 2 times positive 5. So 1 squared is 1. Again, we can think of this two ways. We can think of this as negative 4 times negative 2, that's 8, times 5 is positive 40. So this would be plus 40, or we could think of this as 1 minus positive 4 times negative 2 times positive 5, which is negative 40, which of course would simplify to plus 40. So the discriminant is equal to 41, which is positive, but not a perfect square. So that means this would not simplify perfectly, and therefore we have two real irrational solutions. And for our last example, we have 2x squared plus 8x plus 8 equals 0. So a is equal to 2, b is equal to positive 8, and c is equal to positive 8. So b squared minus 4ac is equal to 8 squared minus 4 times 2 times 8. Well, 8 squared is equal to 64 minus 4 times 2 is equal to 8. And 8 times 8 is equal to 64. So this difference is 0. So the number underneath the square root is equal to 0. Therefore, we only have one repeated real rational solution. The solution would also have a multiplicity of 2. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.